हेलो फ्रेंड, मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर आशुतोष कुमार भट्ट, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, उत्तराखंड ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। सो टुडे आई एम स्टार्टिंग माय फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑन .NET फ्रेमवर्क। सो दिस इज इंट्रोडक्टरी लेक्चर एंड आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ .NET फ्रेमवर्क। एंड .NET इज़ वन ऑफ द न्यू प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज, इट इज़ recent programming language and there are many new feature of this programming language, and this is very useful for web development as well as mobile development. So first of all, the features of .NET framework. .NET is new framework for developing console based, web based and window based application. So you can understand this fact that we can develop console based application. Console based means the application which is designed for only one device, and web based application which are running on the server as well as client system. And we can also develop GUI based application or window based application within the Microsoft environment. And .NET develops client centric to server centric application. So this is one of the very important feature of this .NET programming language. We can develop server centric as well as client centric applications. So these are the main features of this .NET framework. And we have been there are five different services in .NET framework. Framework .NET itself and ASP.NET, web services, Windows form, ADO.NET. So there are different application of each service. ASP.NET basically it is for client and server side communication as well as connectivity, and we can also develop many web services for the website during website development. And for GUI development we have been this Windows forms, and for database connectivity we have ADO.NET. So these are the main services, and apart from these services we have been many new services, and the language is developing day by day. It is increasing its version also. So there are new features are being part of this programming language. So we can say it next generation of the software client and enable anytime, anywhere connecting. And .NET framework managed secure execution environment. So this is also important feature of the .NET framework. It allows developer to create application that target the client software of variety of smart devices. So we can develop the application for the smart devices also. So this is one of the very important feature of this programming language, that we can develop we can develop application for the smart devices. And language interoperability is also it's very important feature. And you can see this diagram where we have been the complete scenario of .NET enterprise vision. So you can see in the upper layer we have been many smart devices like mobile phone, tablet, desktop, laptop, and many other smart devices. And these devices are connected through internet and through different scheduling algorithm as well as authentication algorithm, notification, they are connected with the server. And these servers are ERP server, billing server, customer services server, sales server. So we have been these three layers. So this type of application can be designed by .NET framework. So .NET is capable to develop such a system where we can interface our smart devices with the server. So you can see this time we have been lots of smart devices. So by this software we can develop a system for these this type of the model, this type of the connectivity as well. So .NET has a software framework platform, and it is language neutral, and .NET execute program written in any compliant language. So I have already told you that .NET is language, the most important feature of .NET is language interoperability, or we can say is language neutral. So the .NET executes program written in any compliant language means suppose we have been a number of languages, so any language can be used in .NET framework. So basically it supports more than 50 languages. So maybe this time it supports more than 50 languages. So this is a very important feature of this programming language. However, the previous language are not supports, they are only works on the single language. So this language works, this language supports many other languages, and these languages are .NET, called .NET compliant language. So in this lecture I will also explain you how to write the program in .NET framework. A small program I will explain you. So here you can see another diagram of the .NET framework, .NET architecture. Again, you can see in the upper layer we have been different layer of .NET, Visual Studio .NET. So the complete name of the software where we can execute the .NET program, that is Visual Studio .NET. And its upper layer where we have been Visual Basic, we have been C Sharp or C++ or J Sharp. So this way we have been more than 50 languages. So we have the compiler of each language, and the compiler of each language will compile the program of program written in that respective language. And with help of common language specification, we provide its common shape. And then we have been in third layer, we have ASP.NET for creating web form as well as web services. And on the other side, we have been Windows form for GUI development. And ADO.NET is there for database connectivity. And sometime for data transmission, we have been XML. And we have a strong base class library in .NET architecture. So this strong base library means we have been a large class library where every function is defined. So this language is so powerful because of it has the large and strong base class library. And common language runtime, the program written in any language, either it is written in VB or C++, C Sharp, J Sharp, in any language program, it can be executed by this common language runtime, and finally it is interpreted to, it is interfaced with the operating system. So this is again this same type of diagram where we are comparing the structure of Java programming language as well as .NET programming language. This is also very important figure. So you can see here, this is the comparison between Java technology as well as .NET technology. So in Java technology, we have been Struct, JSP, Servlet, JDBC, J2E, class library, Java runtime. So if we compare it with this Microsoft technology, so you can see here ASP.NET. So this ASP.NET is used for the website or web server designing. So same time in Java technology, we have Struct, JSP, Servlet in place of this ASP.NET. And in .NET framework, we use ADO.NET, while in Java framework we use JDBC. So the both applications are the same, but their purpose also same, but they are written in by the different vendor. They are the provider of these two software are the different vendor. And base class library in .NET also, we have been base class library. However, in Java technology, we have J2E base class library. CLR is there in .NET technology, and while in Java, we have been Java runtime. And finally, in bottom layer, we can execute different type of the application. Same way in Java technology, we also having different operating system as well as applications. So this is the basic difference between these two technologies. And in Java technology, we have been only Java. However, you can see in the left side, leftmost side, we have been different language, VB, C++, C Sharp, Perl, Python. So these are the different languages, and we can execute these all languages in one platform, one architecture. So this is the major feature of this Java technology, because it has the major feature, that is language interoperability. Now in next slide, you can see the historical development of Java, .NET framework. So basically .NET framework, it is subset of the subset of .NET framework, and C Sharp standardized by ECMA, and C Sharp is one of the major compiler of .NET technology. So in .NET we can use VB. When we are using VB, then it is VB.NET. When we are using C Sharp, then it is C Sharp.NET and ASP.NET. So we have been different programming language. So here In this slide, you can see here C#. So C# is the major compiler of .NET family, and it is standardized by ECMA, European Computer Manufacturer Association. So all languages which is developed by any company, they are standardized by the ECMA. ECMA is European Computer Manufacturer Association. Finally, they standardize it and they publish it. So it has given standard international standard in 2001, and co-sponsored with Intel, HP and Microsoft jointly submitted draft of C# to ECMA. So this is the historical background of C#.NET, and C# is a new programming language that combines the feature of Java, C and C#. So it is sharper than C and C++, and C# not only programming language but also an integral part of .NET family. So it is very important compiler of .NET family, and many other features are also associated with .NET framework. These are the automatic garbage collection, automatically clearing of the resources. So these are the other important feature of .NET framework, and it has rich, I have already explained you, rich and enhanced class library. It has this programming language, and GUI support is very important of this programming language, and C# does not allow global function or variable. Everything is in class. So this is the important condition of that writing program while writing programming in C#.NET. So we must have to write all the variable inside the class. We will not write any variable outside the class. C# program do not have header file. Like in C language, we have to write include stdio.h, and in case of the C++, we write include iostream.h, but in case of the C#, we never write any header file. And it means run all platform, not just Windows. So it is platform independent programming language, and we can execute the program of C#.NET on any platform. And language independent is its feature, and component within different language can be mixed easily in the same application. So this is also very important feature, that we can integrate different part of code, different module of the code in one module. So this is also called language interoperability. So these are the different compiler list. So you can see here C#, C, C++, Java, COBOL, JScript, Eiffel, Haskell. So we can execute these programming, different programming language in one framework, and that one framework is called .NET framework. And finally, I am coming this program. So how to write the program in C#.NET? You can see in this slide, always we will write program by using system. So in case of Java, we must have to write import statement, and in C#.NET we have to write here using. So using same as the import. So using system, system is the library, and then we will write semicolon, and then we have been this class as its class, and that's the name of the class. So here name of the class is hello, and after class we will write curly bracket, and we will close it by the curly bracket. And public static void main, it is its main function. So we are writing here only one function, and inside this function we are just giving one message. So static void main, and inside this again we have started by curly bracket and closed by the curly bracket, and we have mentioned here console.writeline. So we will write here this statement to print any message. Like in Java we will write system.out.println. So the same statement here in C#.NET, it is console.writeline. So you can see here inside the simple bracket hello world. So this message will be displayed when we will execute this program. So thank you very much. Thank you.